Hello and welcome to another one of my LeetCode videos. In this one, we'll do LeetCode 2509, cycle length queries in a tree. This is a hard problem. It was part of the contest this week. And so basically I'll summarize the problem. You're given an integer n, which represents the height of this tree. And the nodes can go from 1 to n minus 2 to the n minus 1. So in this case, if n is 3, you know, you can imagine a tree like this where it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, where the it's like an in a level order traversal of the tree. And what we are asked to do is we're given an array queries, and we have to compute the number of edges formed by connecting this node. So let's say we connect node 5 and 3. The answer here is 4 because we have 1, 2, 3, 4 edges. If we connect node 4 and 7, you connect this two, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you have 5 edges. So basically connecting any two nodes, you know, what is the length of the you know, the formed enclosing shape? And yeah, so what will our approach be here? So when I initially thought about this problem, I thought, okay, in order to get the length of the shape enclosing it, basically it's you have to traverse to the lowest common ancestor of these two nodes, right? So if you look at 4 and 7, one is the lowest common ancestor. So it's like the path from 4 to the common ancestor is 2. The path from 7 to the common ancestor is also 2, plus the 1, which is connecting 4 and 7. So given any two nodes, we find the path to the lowest common ancestor and then add the connecting node 1. So in this case, let's say if it was 6 and 7 connected, then, you know, it's 1, the lowest common ancestor is 3, so it's going to be 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is a total of 3. And in this case, the lowest common ancestor is 1, so the distance from 1 to the lowest common ancestor is 0. For 2, it's 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1 plus the edge between them, which is 2. So the answer is going to be 0 plus 1 plus 1, 2. And so the next, so that's a workable approach. But then if you notice, there's going to be so many queries here. You know, we can have up to 10 to the 5 queries. And if we compute the lowest common ancestor, like using the classical way for every node, it's going to take a long time. So I thought, how can I optimize computing the lowest ancestor, the lowest common ancestor? And then one thing I tried to use is the fact that this is a binary tree with a given pattern, right? So maybe we can apply a formula to get to the ancestor and compute it quickly, right? Rather than actually like treating these as random nodes and finding the lowest common ancestor. So let me draw that out for you real quick so you can visualize what I'm talking about. Okay, so here I've drawn I've converted these numbers to binary and drawn the binary search tree or the binary tree, right? So if you notice, if I shift my number to the right, I get my parent node. That's a very useful insight because basically let's say if I shift 101 to the right, if I right shift it by 1, I'll end up with 10, which is actually its parent. If I shift 111 to the right, I end up with 11, which is actually its parent, right? So basically, if I compute all the, let's say if I have to connect this node and this node, I would compute all the parents and store them in a map of the parent to the distance, right? So in this case, the first parent, I shift it by right, it's going to be 2, and the distance of the 2 node is 1. Then the second parent, I shift this one by right shift by 1, it's going to be 1. And then I put a key of 1 and a value of 2 because the distance is 2, right? So basically I keep shifting it to the right and keeping track of the distance. And then that's what I do for the first node. And then for the second node, I do the same until I run into a common node, right? So let's say in this case, the common node will be 1. So then I look up saying, okay, for 1, the distance is 2 to the first node. So and then I keep track of the distance to get to that common node. So in this case, it'll be just 1. So it's gonna be 2 over here plus 1 for the second node. and then we'll add one because there's a line between these two. And that will max out at the height of the tree, because if you notice, n cannot be greater than 30. So 30 is a very small number if you look at the number of queries and, you know, the number of nodes that can be in the tree. So let's try and code that solution and see how that goes. So the first thing we'll need is just an array of answers so that we can store our answers and return it. So I've gone ahead and created our answers array and returned answers, and it's going to be queries.length, because for each query we're going to store the answer in this array. Now the next thing we want to do is just loop through the queries and then store the answer in the answers array. So let me do that real quick. Yep, so I've gone ahead and done that, and then now I just want to store our two numbers in some variable, because we'll keep shifting them to the right and we don't want to modify the original array. So let's capture those two variables. So these are our two nodes. Now, next thing we want to do is we want to compute the hash map for the first node to all the way to the root, right? So we'll have a map of just integer to say node to distance, right? Yeah, and then this node will contain basically, you know, the upward traversal and the distance, you know, for this node. So initially our distance will be equal to 0, and we'll store this initial value in the node. So I've gone ahead and stored that onto our list, and then now since the root node is 1, we'll say while first not equal to 1. So while we haven't reached the top node, I'm just going to say first is equal to first left shift or right shift 1, which is basically getting to the parent of 1, and then store that in our node to distance map. So we're going to say first and distance. I'm also going to increment my distance, right? So I initially put my first node, and then while we haven't reached the top node, we keep shifting it to the right, increment our distance, and update that into our node to distance. So in this case, for the case of, let's say, 5, the node to distance will look like 5, 0, and then the parent of 5 will be 2, 1, and then the parent of 2 would be 1, and the distance 2. So this is how our map would look like. And now what we need to do is take our second node. So in this example, it's 3. We want to take our second node and do the same thing until we find a node that is in the first map. So we can just say, okay, int steps for second is equal to 0. And our terminal condition is while not node to distance dot contains key second, right? Because if we find this, we'll keep going up, right? And so if we find the node in the path of the first node, then that's when we stop our loop, right? So while we haven't found this one, what we'll do is we'll increment our steps per second, and then we'll right shift the second because reach the parent of second. Right, so we'll keep going up until we hit a common path. So in this case, if you imagine, let's say the nodes were 6 and 7, we'd have 6 go up all the way up to 1, and then for 7, as soon as we hit 3, we'll find that it's already in the map, and then we'll stop. And then at the end, what we want to do is we want to compute the distance to the common node. The final answer will basically be the steps for the second node. Basically, this is how long it took for the second node to reach the common ancestor, plus the steps for the first node to reach the common ancestor is going to be basically this one, node to distance dot get second, because second will now, after this loop, second will be equal to the common node because we found that. And so when we do node to distance dot get second, this is the distance that it took for the first node to get here, right? And then we want to add 1 because there's also an edge connecting these two. And so, yes, I believe that's it. Let's try to run the code now. Oh, there is a error. I should be doing queries at i0 and i1. I misspelled node to distance. This should be answers. All right, cool. We have passed the two test cases. Let's submit. Perfect. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.